Good morning students, ਤੇ ਅੱਜ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਰਨ ਜਾ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ lesson number 5 fundamental unit of life as we have already studied in class 8 that the an organism is made up of cells a cell is a structural and functional unit of life here we in the 9th class we will study about more about the cell and its organelles so, first of all who found the cell that is the Robert Hooke is the name of that scientist in 1665 who observed the cork of the bark of the tree under a microscope at that time the microscope was not so developed so it's looked like a comb of bees' backs so that boxes are known Robert Hooke gave name cell to that part it is the still these units is being used till this day in the biology still we call that unit is known as cell what are the living organism made up of I have already told that when he observed under the microscope he observed small boxes that is called the cells similarly we can observe the cells of plants as well as animals we have already done this activity in class 8th also as we observe the peel of onion under the microscope and like figure 5.2 we see the cells like that that is the onion peel because onion is a plant so that's why it is a plant cell similarly we can see the animal soul also by scratching the inner side of our cheeks by toothpicks slight softly then the bits of the material that comes on the toothpick we can observe under the microscope we can see the animal cells as well what are these structures actually these structures look like similar to each other they form a big structure like onion bulb we find them from this activity that bulbs of different sizes have similar small structures means like if we want to construct a house then we need the bricks are similar however what is the size whatever is the size of the house or room but the all the bricks are same similarly organism is made up of a as much as of size but the basic unit is always cell the smallest structure from which the organism formed is called a cell so that is called it is a basic structural unit of life cells were first discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665 then by primitive microscope after that with the developed improved microscopes Robert Brown was a scientist in 1831 who observed nucleus in the cell Purkinje is another scientist who coined the term protoplasm for the fluid found in the cell theory that all the plants and animals composed of cells and the cell is basic unit of life was presented by two scientists that is Sheldon and Schwann that's why it's also known as cell theory Sheldon-Schwann theory the cell theory was further expanded by Virchow by suggesting that all cells rises from pre-existing cells means nothing is new that new cells comes from the pre-existing cells with the discovery of electron microscope in 1940 it was possible to observe understand the complex structure of cells and its organelles till that only that is known the cell has a protoplasm nucleus and cell wall or membrane other small organelles can we understand and by the electron microscope invention of magnifying lenses led to discovery of microscopic world it is now known that single cell may be constitute a whole organism as we already know in the class 8th we have studied that there are some animals or organism which are made up of only one cell like amoeba paramecium euglena they are formed from only single cell and single cell is a whole organism on the other hand cells of may form the groups together and form a body or assume different functions that is also we have done that some organisms are made up of more than one cell that are known as multicellular organisms and multicellular organisms has some form has come from single cells and they produce own kind of cells and form a group of cells so all cells come from the pre-existing cells their sizes the organisms have different kinds of cells as they depend upon their function and their location here are some figure 5.3 some types of cells are shown rbcs smooth muscle cells, ovum, bone cells, sperm, nerve cell and fat cell are shown here. These are the very important diagrams for the multiple choice questions. Size and shape of cells related to, I have already told you that it is related to the function and their location they perform, and amoeba can change its shape, it has not a particular shape. Nerve cell is the typical shape, it is longest cell in the body. Each living cell has capacity to perform all the basic functions of that organisms. So it's why, that's why it is also known as cell is a structural and functional unit of life, because every function that is needed for the life, like respiration, digestion, etc., every cell has to perform its own function. But a cell made up of understructural organization of cell, that topic we will do tomorrow. Thank you.